sunshine. Thank you for rain. Thank you for joy. Thank you for pain. It's a beautiful day. It's a beautiful day.
Hi, everybody. Happy 2023. Happy New Year. My name is Maria, by the way. And thank you so much for coming to my channel today. Go ahead and like, subscribe, and comment where you're watching from. Without further ado, let's get into this video. And what you are about to watch is just a day in my life, getting ready with me and getting to work. So, without further ado, drum rolls, let's go. 2023, we got started right. And today is January the 2nd. Come get ready with me. Let's go get coffee and let's chit chat about life. And so without further ado, let's say bye to the towel, this phase, blah, blah, blah. And let's get started. Anyway, so first things first, let's brush our teeth, right? Blah, blah, blah. Then what we do is I wash my face. Let me see if I have a towel, and I do have a face towel. I have a face towel and I use it like I get a new face towel like every 2 days. So every day I have to use a face scrub, and this is just a generic one at Target. Blemish Control Apricot Scrub from Target. Because I have very oily skin. So every day I have to exfoliate my skin. If not, I get super, super, super breakouts. Which I have one right there. But it's because I was eating a bunch of chocolate. I am on my period. I've been eating a bunch of peanuts and a bunch of stuff I really shouldn't be eating. But anyways, wash your face. And pat it dry. Pat it, pat it, pat it, pat it, pat it. So nice and dry, nice and clean. Then that's in the dirty clothes bin. Then I like to go in and apply a toner, and this is by Artistry. This is a brand that I love so much, you guys. I've had this toner for over a year, and I'm barely halfway. I don't use that much because I don't like my skin super wet. I like it to dry fast. But I definitely gotta figure something out for this melasma or whatever that I got from my previous from my one and only pregnancy. Then I'm just gonna apply this thing here, and I gotta dye my hair, so I'll show you guys in the next video how I dye my hair or whatever. We'll see. I have my makeup already here ready. So I just want to make sure my toner is nice and dry. Mm-hmm.
nice and dry. Then the one that I like to use is, I like to use this Wet n Wild Last Correct primer base, because it corrects the color. Oh my gosh, and I forgot my sponge. Hold on one second, guys. To get ready, I like to wear like comfy clothes. So I'm in my lounge wear. And then I got Target pants, Target top, Target slippers. So anyways, I just like to apply this green stuff on my face. All over. Last year I did so many wrong things and I didn't set my priorities all the way straight. I became a mom for the very first time and that was a thing. My baby shower is freaking awesome. My wedding was awesome. Oh, but that was not last year. That's so crazy. So last year was my baby shower and my birth. I definitely want to do a video of my birth and all the things that nobody told me about, because everybody says, oh, it hurts so much. Like, I was like, whatever, you guys are trying to scare me, blah, 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 you know? And I really, really wanted to have a baby when I knew, when I met my husband, our first day conversation was all the things I had ever been scared of to ask any other guy. And I wish I would have thought about asking, because I feel like, you know, I didn't want to scare the guys off, but those relationships and those things ended anyways, so I wish I would have asked. But next up, I'm gonna add the Forever Dior, and it's so dirty. It is the Extreme Wear Moisturizing Primer Correction Protection Elimination with Sunscreen. So let's add that baby up. Let's add that baby up. Blend, blend, blend. Blend, blend. So anyways, I really wish I would have asked those, like, all those guys, like, the tough questions that every woman, every girl, every lady should ask. You know, like, do you want to have kids? Do you want to get married? Do you agree? Like, what religion are you? You know? Because it doesn't matter what anybody says, in my opinion, that even though you were raised into that religion and you don't practice it, you don't believe, blah, 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 in some ways, we have been brainwashed to believe us in a certain way, right? So, on our first date, like on our official first date, like we went to a church in LA, which is Fivefold Ministry, amazing church. You guys need to check that out on YouTube, Instagram. I think they're even on TikTok. So it's 5F Fold, like. Fivefold Church, 5F Ministry or something like that, by Catherine Crick. Anyways, I took him there because we're both Christians, you know, so I really wanted to test him out and see if, like, are you really a Christian or are you just saying that you are, just to look good. And yeah, so on our way there, we were like talking about like from our previous dating situations and like all that stuff, you know. So I asked Sean, like, what are you looking for? Are you looking for a girlfriend? Like, you know, what is your deal now? We're both in our 30s. And I had become a Christian in 2014. So I was on that road of searching and trying to find the answers to how I should live and how I wanted to live and blah, blah, blah. So we went there, and then on our way back, I was like, you know, like, I feel like being at church with him and knowing that he was like truly a Christian, a practicing Christian and stuff like that, I was like, okay, so I think it's now or never, right? Like, either I ask these questions and I know the answer, and even if they're painful, even if those answers are not the answers that I want to hear, at least I'll know, I'll be prepared, and then I make a wise decision. I make a decision based on, you know, what we talked about and how I would feel and all that stuff. You get me? So then I was like, do you want to have kids? Do you want to get married? Like, what do you think about all this stuff? And he was like so on. He was like, yes, I want to get married. Yes, I want to have kids. I just haven't found the woman that wants that too, you know? I want to fall in love and I want to have kids with the person that I love the most and the person that is aligned with my lifestyle. And he told me that it was really important for him to marry a Christian, and it was really important to him, like, you know. And mind you, I had already quit drinking. So anyways, back to this is the foundation that I'm wearing right now. It's by Milani, and it's concealer and perfect 2-in-1. It's in sand beige, number 6, and I really like it because it's not too much, but it does like make my skin look a lot better from all the melasma that I got from my pregnancy. And I forgot my under eye stuff. So for my under eyes, I'm going to wear by A Cosmetics. It's full coverage, anti-aging. Full coverage. Oh, it doesn't want to focus. Anyways, it's full coverage anti-aging waterproof concealer. So, and I like to use the same sponge. I like it. I don't know, this works for me. I've always done this, and I just like the basics. I'm not an MUA or anything like that. So I like to add concealer to the darker places of my face, which happen to be under my eyes. Under my nose. And over here on my lips, like this little dark spot here. And I like to blend it in, pulling it through to the back, around my nose, and blend it there. Blend. So anyways, I decided to go for it, and I said, look, I'm already in my 30s. I have nothing to lose. I need to ask these questions because I need to know, you know? I don't want to be dragged along in a 2, 3, 4-year-old relationship and not know what it is that we want and where we want to go. I was done with that lie. Like, I had already had my heart broken 3 times. 4 times. So, I was done with that, guys. And it paid off because that was exactly what he wanted. He wanted to get married and get pregnant right away, you know? And he was a sweetheart from the start, first off. Like, he was the biggest sweetie, and like, I've never met a man to talk to his mom the way that Sean talks to his mom. Like, he calls his mom literally, and they're both like, hey, sweetie. And then his mom is like, hey, cupcake, peanut butter pie. You know? And it's like the cutest thing. And I'll never forget one time. I've pretty much worked in retirement homes on and off. And right now I'm at a rehab center, post-op, stuff like that, place. And he told me, like, when I first started, back when I was 19, he told me, he was the sweetest little Jewish guy. He was like, hey, I want you to know something. I want you to be wise. It looks so much better in the mirror. Look. Can you see? No, you can't really see. Oh, there it is. Yeah, it looks so much better in the mirror. So, blend. Oh, this light is like terrible. It looks terrible on the phone. But anyways, trust the process. Trust the process, guys. He was like, yeah. Pay attention how a guy treats his mom, because how he treats his mom is how he's going to treat you. Nothing like stuck to me like that little guy back in the day. And it's so true, because the boyfriends that I had previously had, they like some of them treated their mom like crap. And then they ended up treating me like crap. So I really always thought about what that guy said, you know, what he had told me back when I was 19. I always remember that. I was like, Maria, you should have listened the way that you should have listened to that guy. He told you, he warned you, be careful. The way he treats his mom is how he's going to treat you. And he was so right, guys. He was absolutely right. So anyways, next up, I'm going to wear the Mineral Physicians Formula Loose Powder in the color... Oh, and this has SPF 16 too. It's medium beige. Basically, what I do is I grab a little bit of that, and it comes with its own little sponge applicator, but I don't like it because I like my brush better. So what I basically do is I dip my powder, my brush in here where the powder is. Then I grab the lid and I basically like go like this and tap it off. And then just close my eyes and apply it all over my face. It doesn't matter where you start. And you can do this as many times as you want. And I close my eyes because my eyes are really, really sensitive. and I can't really get makeup on in my eyes because I'll literally hurt the entire day. So I'll add a little bit more. Same process. Just like so. Looking at the girl in the mirror. Anyways, so then that's that. Then I grab my e.l.f. little brush and I do my matte bronzer by NYX in the color medium. See how much I love this, guys. It's literally, I use it every single time I do my makeup. So what I do is I start at the ends and I go in. This girl likes to be a little bronzed. I do it at the bottom too, to mimic those shadows. I go down to my neck because you can't be all dined up and then your neck, like, there's nothing. It's gotta match a little bit at least. So anyways, let's hurry this process up because I don't want to be here all day. Today I want to go visit Sunny too, by the way, take her some flowers, something like that. Like this. The lighting is not good here, guys. Don't like it. And then I go over with a little brush. These little brushes are for your eyebrows and for your eyelashes, or more for your eyelashes, but I like to use them for my eyebrows because it takes off the makeup that I applied on my face off of my eyebrows, so then my eyebrows can be naturally bushy, and I like that natural look. I already have a lot of eyebrows, so I don't really like to do much to that. Then, the last but not least, or one of the last but not least, is eyeliner, because I always pretty much wear eyeliner. So let me go over here and apply it. I like a little bit of tail. Pretty much only. See that? It's just the tail. just the tale. But comment down below what you guys got for Christmas. Because Christmas just passed. So before I filmed you guys or saw you guys or filmed me, before starting, I actually took a bath without washing my hair because I wash my hair 2 to 3 times a week only. I don't like to over dry my hair at all. But after I do my makeup, I like to wash my hands because a lot of that makeup stuff sticks to my hands. And you will see how dirty this water is. Let me see if I can. Well, anyways, I'll do that and then you guys could see like me rinsing my hand. Oh, it didn't come out dirty today, surprisingly. Let's see this one. And didn't come out too dirty today either. But because of that sponge and those brushes and all that, then my hands end up with like a ton of makeup. So next up, we're gonna do my hair. I don't like to do much because I like it like kind of natural. I don't like my hair overly done. So. Oh, but one thing I forgot my setting spray, so let me go get that. And I'm using the Tarte Marucula Miracle Mist. I barely have any left, so. It says that it lasts, sets makeup for 16 hours, which it does pretty good because I work from 3 to 11 today, so my makeup has to be good. Okay, so I don't spray that much, honestly. There we go. I like my makeup more natural, guys, and my look more of a natural look. Just, that's my style. That's always been my style. I don't like to be... This is one of my favorite hair brushes, by the way. It's one of those wet and dry. I take it with me in the shower most of the time because I have such long hair. And it's all plastic too, like those bristles. And I've had it for like 2 years. I had it before I had my baby. Or right before, maybe when I was pregnant. So, my hair is so long, I need a haircut. So I basically brush it through. And what do we want to do today? Today I think I want to do a ponytail. Yeah, I'm going to do a low ponytail. Hair literally looks like one of those extensions ponies. I'm gonna do this. And what I use for my hair is these that I got at Walmart. They're like the daycare thingies. Then I'm not sure exactly what I want to wear. So, and I don't like to apply. I guess I could, but whatever. I'll apply some hairspray for you guys. For my hair, I like to use the same company, which is by Amway. My toner is by Amway, but it's called Artistry. It's the Artistry line at Amway. And for my hair, I like to use the Satinique brand by Amway. It's just so good. It's the thing that transforms my hair. And next time I wash my hair, I'm also gonna make a video too. So comment down below if you stuck this long, and say hi to me. Tell me where you're from, and what kind of stuff you're excited for this year, for 2023, or what kind of stuff you're so excited to be done with 2022. And let's make this year great, guys. So I'm just gonna, there we go. Just for those little hairs. I don't like to really add too much hairspray or anything like that, if ever. But this hairspray is so good because it's shiny and it doesn't make your hair like flake. It doesn't flake or whatever. And by the way, the best hair holder from Amazon, I got like 4 of these or 6 of these, and I gave some away. Ooh, as gifts, because I love them that much, and they lasted me. So I was like, you know what, I want other people to experience this. But look how easy that is, and my hair looks like it's an extension ponytail, literally. Let me wash my hands again. Just because I don't like to have that hairspray stuff on my hands. I don't. So anyways, I'm just gonna keep it super natural. I'm not gonna add any mascara or eyeshadow. I like it natural. I really do. So anyways, let me go change and see what I want to pick for today. I gotta get ready too for work at 3. And I really want to sit down with you guys and talk about all that CNA stuff. Because if you want to be in the medical industry, if you want to become a CNA, there's a lot of things that I want to talk to you guys about. And yeah. So anyways, give me a few minutes. Chop, 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 chop. I'll be right back. Guys, I'm getting gas really quickly. Well, sipping on my caramel macchiato. This is probably my top 3 drinks. My top 3 drinks are caramel macchiato, chai latte, and just regular iced coffee, I think. Yeah. All right, let's get going. Hey guys, I'm at my work bathroom. Had to change, get into my scrubs, and I'm ready. I am ready. My mask on, my coffee, second coffee of the day. Okay. Oh,
for rain. Thank you for joy. Thank you for pain. It's a beautiful day. It's a beautiful day.